Get in the way. Go clear the way. We're walking. Clear the way. We're walking.
David, you told me earlier in the week that your performance tonight was going to signal the start of the David Benavidez era. And boy, oh boy, did you do that. Or were you surprised in what you were able to do in the fashion that you were able to do it, because you really turned up the heat rather quickly against Demetrius Andre?
I'm not surprised. I know how hard I worked in this camp, and like I've been telling everybody for a long time that the fights were won in the training camp. I didn't leave any stone unturned in the training camp. I worked my ass off, and I think it just shows. I mean, there's a lot of critics that say Boo Boo's gonna outbox me, that my defense is not good, I'm gonna get hit. They said the same thing with Caleb Plant, and I continue to keep shutting all the critics up. You know, you guys say I can't do something, but I go in there and I look completely different than what you guys think I look like. You know, so it's better the critics to keep their mouths shut, because I'm listening to everything you guys are saying.
Yeah, you've been put on notice. We now have questions for the champion, David Benavidez.
Three WBC belts right here. I'm the best in the division. If they want to give me an opportunity now or later, I'm gonna keep winning. You know, like I said, I'm gonna be the greatest of my generation by the time I'm done.
He's only 26 years of age. How about that? Only 26. Unbelievable. Questions for David Benavidez.
Where you at?
What's that water you drinking?
Shout out to my sponsor, this is Agua Plus.
Oh, it's great, water. It looks good in your hand.
The best water out
it
there.
It looks good. It looks great.
It's the best water.
It's the best water in the world.
That's right, it's the best water.
Decision after the first two rounds to go to the body instead of the head?
Yeah, I wanted to start off slow. You know he was trying to set me up for some traps. And, I'm not new to this. As much as you guys try to act like, I'm young and dumb, I don't know what's coming. I've been watching boxing my whole life. I've been boxing since I was 3 years old. I've been professional 10 years. I sparred Golovkin when I was 15 years old, Kelly Pavlik 15 years old, so I know how to switch it up. I know how to handle every other style. So Demetrius Andre, he was great, he was fast, he's trying to set me up, but the way you throw off the rhythm is a double jab right hand. I do that the first two rounds, and then I switched up to the right hook, and that's what opened up all the openings. I dropped him, and then he never recovered after that.
You feel like you're in your prime or entering your prime now?
Yeah, I'm definitely entering my prime. I think just the passion I have in the sport, wanting to make my dad and my mother show up proud of me.
Okay, let me get a statement for Canelo. Regardless of the result, if Canelo fight Benavidez, it be an idol if he fight him. If he doesn't fight him, it will not be ever an idol. Now, regardless, if he wins, it be the best. And if he lose, he have the balls to go with the best. So, Canelo, no run anymore.
No run, baby!
And whoever say that I tell you what, I give you $1,000 now if you tell me any other fight besides Canelo and Benavidez. Give me another fight that everybody won.
I want to tell everybody, my whole team, I just want to thank everybody. Also I want to thank my wife, my mother, my father, my brother. He's always pushed me since I was a little kid, and I'm just happy to be here, I'm really happy. And thank you all for coming.
David, congratulations on a wonderful performance tonight. Marcus Hayes, Fight Up Television. I wanted to ask you,
In those moments where you are absorbing punches, what is it inside of you that makes you come back so adamantly and so vehemently?
It's that fighting spirit. You know, that's where I learned sparring world champions when I was 14, 15 years old. If you hit me one, two shots back, I'm gonna come back with 5, 6. That's always how it's been. Like I said, I have the strongest fighting spirit in the world. That's why I know I'll beat anybody they put in front of me, because I love this. I love getting hit, and I love hitting back.
And lastly for me, champ, I just wanted to ask you, what do you think that this knockout showed Canelo Alvarez tonight?
For Canelo and everybody else, it just shows everybody I'm not fucking around. I'm here to say
it. The WBC convention, they declared that the winner of this fight would be the mandatory for Canelo, but Carlos Adames has been the mandatory for over a year for Charlo. That hasn't been enforced. Is there a concern on your part that even though you are the mandatory challenger now, that it won't be enforced?
I mean, I just look at the facts. You know, the people want to see this fight more than Carlos Adames and Charlo. You know, that's why that fight hasn't happened. But for me and Canelo, we have motion. You know what I mean? I've been winning the fights I'm supposed to win in fantastic fashion. He has nobody else to fight. You know what I mean? So if they want to give it to me now, later, whenever, I'm not going nowhere.
By the way, you are Ecuadorian, like my wife, and I've been married for 50 years. And I love her so much, and half Mexican. Mm-hmm. But Canelo said that he wanted to fight the Mexican. So, about if you go to next time with him.
You know, there's so much things I had to go through to get to this level. You know, sometimes when you're little, you gotta go through beatings to know how it feels, you know what I mean? But now, you know, I just feel like, you know, the defense is good. It's not like I was getting hit the whole fight, you know? But you know, if you gotta eat a shot here and there, you can't let it discourage you. You gotta come back and be stronger. You gotta get some type of energy after you get hit like that. If not, you know, the fight's not gonna go your way.
That's right. Pedro Guerra, UNLV TV. David, obviously huge turnout for you and your brother tonight. During the fourth round, the crowd started chanting "Si se puede," and shortly after you scored the knockdown. For you, how did that energy feel inside the ring?
It felt amazing, man. That's why I want to be this type of fighter that brings these type of excitement to the crowd, because at the end of the day, if you're that type of fighter, you really feed off the energy and you feel the energy. And like I said, my fans are everything to me. If I can make some fans go crazy like that, and you know, I feel the energy, then I'm just gonna keep giving you guys the types of fights you want to see. And I really do appreciate all the love from the fans I get. You know, it really makes me happy and it really motivates me a lot.
Just two more guys.
Hey, Darwin. Sí, háblanos de la estrategia, David, acá. Háblanos de la estrategia. Dos rounds y parecía como que ibas a dejar al rival que hiciera su pelea. Después cambiaste la estrategia y te fuiste a la cabeza y definiste la pelea.
No, pues yo quería empezar un poquito despacio porque sí sabía que el Demetrius Andrade tenía bastante rapidez, se movía mucho. So no quería tirar de más, pero cuando le pegué, yo creo que era en el primer round, le pegué con un hook y se miró que se lastimó un poquito y ahí le puché al gas un poquito más y no, pues salí con el knockout.
Well, regarding the strategy, I wanted to pace myself. I didn't want to burn myself out too fast. But once I got him in the first round with a good punch, I saw that he was kind of shaken up, and that's when I started, you know, revving it up a lot more. And then, you know, things went from there.
Ellie. You got one more? Last question,
Ellie.
Go ahead. Okay. Go ahead. No microphone. So, David, you just beat a 2-division champion, undefeated, most avoided guy. Where are you on the pound for pound right now, according to yourself?
I don't know, to be honest.
Real quick, David, so because you didn't have a microphone, Ellie's question was where David sees himself on the pound for pound list. What, David?
Like I said, I want to be humble in victory too. I don't think I've done enough to make it on the pound for pound list, but I will definitely get there. But I think what this victory shows, I mean, a lot of people said he's going to be too much, too this, blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean? I know how to go in there and I know how to get the victory. I know how to find the victory. You know what I mean? And that's, I think that, you know, it lets people know I'm very dangerous. Yes. You know, it's not just one style I fight in. There's more, multiple styles I fight in. You know, and I can break fighters down. I can break boxers down. I can break power punches down. It don't matter to me. And I think with this victory, I'm really getting very comfortable in there. You know, I'm getting very comfortable with the crowd, very comfortable with everything, and I'm just going in there having a good time, because at the end of the day, this is what we love to do. So when you got a fighter like me going in there enjoying every minute and every second of that ring, you know, you're just gonna get a dangerous, dangerous fighter, and this is what I love to do, and I'm gonna continue doing this.
Last question in the back.
Performance. You mentioned the Dmitry Bivol fight earlier. If you were to move up to 175, there's no denying you're a big guy at 168. Do you think you would stick to 175 then, or any chance you would come back down, depending on how you feel?
I mean, I feel like once I move up to 175, I don't know. I have to see how I feel. But I mean, I'll definitely come back down. The Dmitry Bivol fight is a great fight because I've sparred him before, you know, and I'm not trying to discredit Dmitry Bivol, but I know what can be done in that fight. He's a great, great fighter, and these are the type of chances I want to take in my career, and I just want to be the best, and I know I'm gonna accomplish that.
All right, David, before we get ready to let you go, obviously, what a memorable performance here in Las Vegas, your second straight pay-per-view headlining. You get better and better. What do you want to tell the fans out there that continuously watch you as you put a bow on what was a tremendous 2023 for David Benavidez?
I just want to say welcome to the David Benavidez era. Woo!